I thank God for Jesus. Jesus is so good to me. I went to the doctor yesterday, and you know, I just had a great time at the doctor. And the Lord used me there, and the blood room. I went. What time I left here? About 9:45, I think it was. I got back here about 3:30, and the doctor seen me and said, "Well, I can't do nothing now. You got to give me blood." So the lady had me in the wait. The doctor had me in the wait about another 40 minutes. But the lady came that got me for the blood. I was looking at her expression on her face. She was frowning up at the people. But once I got in there with her, it was a different situation, because when the Lord brought me before her, I started asking. I said, "I sure hope you good with this needle, because you ain't gonna get number one shot. That's it." So she said, "Well, you better call on the name of Jesus." I said, "All right. Oh, I won't call on the name of Jesus with you." So me and her started talking about the Lord in there, and I said, "You know, you just doing your job." She said, "I wish the other people that come in here can hear this, because they'd be so rude to me." I said, "There's no need to be rude."
Right.
No. I said, you just doing your job. You're trying to help them.
Right.
And that was the last part of the session. I got another part to tell you, too. But what happened was the lady was up front, and she said, "Who just said that?" I said it. She said, "You're so right." I said, "I thank God for how he's going to change my life."
Yeah.
Because I know God changed me, instead of changing me, I want to be like Jesus if I can go back to heaven.
Amen.
And when the first time I went to the doctor's office, they had a young man came in there. And his mother was telling everybody that he can't do the things he used to do because his body being so much pain. And the funny thing about the situation the young man was in, he went to Blake. He said he died 4 times. And that opened the door for me. I said, "Young man, do you go to church?" He said, "Yes." He was so polite, but you know, with what the world dealt to him is his facial appearance. But you never know what a person have in their heart. He was polite, he was kind. He said, "I had a chance to be a professional football player. But I said, God had different plans for you." I said, "You know, about your sickness," I said, I go to church right in the back of here, this doctor's office. I said, "I go to church." I said, "Come into the church and get your healing." I said, "People is getting healed here, delivered here, and set free here at this church." He said, "I'm coming," him and his mother. And I just thank God for yesterday. And I just love the Lord. I'm striving to be like Jesus. If I offend anyone, I'm sorry. And I just thank God for all that he has done for my life. And going to do for my life. I got another testimony. I think I told Pastor Rose, I'm not for sure. When I went to the disability hearing, they had this other lawyer from Tampa they gave me. And this lawyer here, to me, he didn't have the experience I was looking for. And he wrote me a letter yesterday saying, "You owe me $35. I said, "I owe you $35 for what?" So I called the head, David Gozak. I called him. And I said, "This man said I owe him $35. He said, "Send us this thing to a fax." So he did. And I read the letter again today or yesterday, I can't remember. But I read the letter. He said, I'm not no longer over your case. I said, God, I sure thank you for that. God, I thank you for that because I'm seeing God start working in my life now. And I just praise God, man, for this church. I praise God for my pastor, his wife. I praise God for everybody in this church. Because we should love one another, be faithful. Man, I want to be faithful. You know, I can make a whole lot of excuses why not come to church. I stay right next door to the church. But I got to be faithful. I need Jesus to do a whole lot of stuff for me, spiritually and naturally. I just want to grow in God and be obedient. You know, I did something today. God taught me a great lesson in it. I cleaned up something. And that lesson was obedience. And God humbled me through that. I told Pastor Rowe, I said, Pastor Rowe, you know, God showed me about Joseph in this situation I was in. And I humbled myself through that. I could have kicked a fit and told Pastor Rowe, I ain't doing that. That stuff wasn't, you know. But it's not about that. It's God looking at my heart. I want God to be pleased with me. I want the Lord to be pleased with me. I don't want to take up too much time. Thank you. Amen.